Hi friends, today we will see the effects of armature reaction. So because of the armature reaction, so there are two things will happen. So first one is cross magnetizing effect. So it is nothing but a distortion of main field flux. Okay, and next one is demagnetizing effect. That means reduction in the main field flux, demagnetizing effect. Okay, so because of cross magnetizing effect, okay, so there will be three things happen. So first one is iron loss, okay, and second one is commutation, poor commutation will happen, and third one is sparking. Okay, this is also coming under the commutation. So fourth one will happen because of the demagnetizing effect. So cost of the field winding. So these are the four things will happen because of the armature reaction. These first three things will happen because of the cross magnetizing effect. And the last one will happen because of the demagnetizing effect. So now let us see one by one. So iron losses. Iron losses depends on magnetic flux density in the teeth and pole shoes. Okay, so iron losses depends on the magnetic flux density. Okay, so magnetic flux density, it depends on flux density, not the flux. Okay, so this is the cross magnetizing effect. Okay, so because of the cross magnetizing effect, the main field flux distorted like this. So here the flux will be more, flux density will be more. Okay, so because of this more flux density in the pole shoes, so this is the pole shoe and teeth. Okay, so teeth will be here. Okay, so the iron losses will be increased. Okay, iron losses will be increased, right? That is the first one. Okay, and second one, commutation. Okay, so what will happen to the commutation? So commutation I didn't discuss till now. We'll discuss it in the next videos. So actually this is the axis of commutation. Okay, so along that brushes will be there. Okay, so because of the some flux will be there. Actually, if there is no load, there is no flux here. Because of the armature reaction, there will be some flux exists along the commutator axis. Okay, so here it will be zero flux now. Okay, so because of this flux distortion, there will be some flux exists along this commutator axis, that is GNA. Okay, so because of that flux, okay, so there will be EMF induced in the coil undergoing commutation. Okay, so commutation process occurs along this axis. Okay, so if there is no armature reaction, here the flux is zero. Okay, so if there is an armature reaction, the flux along this axis is not zero. So because of that flux, so EMF induced in the coil undergoing commutation. Okay, the coil undergoing commutation. So because of that EMF, okay, the commutation process is delayed. Understand? The commutation process is delayed. That means the current, the reversal of current does not take place within the time. So the commutation process is delayed. Because of that, there will be small sparking occurs. Okay, so that is the poor commutation process. Okay, so next one, third one is sparking. So the sparking also will come under this commutation. So if the voltage induced, okay, so if the voltage induced in the coil undergoing commutation is exceeds more than 30 to 40 volts because of the more load, understand, because of the heavy loads, okay, then what will happen? The mica insulation will be breakdown. Sometimes the mica insulation breakdown and sparking occurs, and this sparking may spread over the entire commutator, and it will appear as a ring. It will appear as a fire of ring fire. Understand? The same thing what happens in the commutation, okay, the sparking also the same thing, but if the voltage exceeds more than 30 to 40 volts because of heavy loads, okay, so sometimes the mica insulation may break down and sparking will occur due to delayed commutation, so that sparking may spread to the entire commutator and it will appear as a ring fire. Okay, so that is not good, that is a poor commutation. Okay, so that is called sparking. Okay, next one, fourth one. So fourth one, what is this? Cost of the field winding. So this occurs because of the demagnetizing effect. Okay, so demagnetizing effect means the flux will be reduced. Okay, so if the flux is reduced in the generator, EMF will be reduced, and in the motor torque will be reduced. Okay, but to maintain the same flux, okay, you have to increase the number of turns in the field winding. Otherwise, you have to keep thick wires. So whatever it may be, if you increase the number of turns or if you use the thick wires, the cost of the field winding is increased. Okay, so these are the four effects of the armature reaction. Okay, so now we will see how to reduce this armature reaction. Okay, methods to reduce armature reaction. Methods to reduce armature reaction. So first one, okay, so first one, by using camphor poles, CHAMPERED, camphor poles. That means, so this is the armature. Okay, so generally the poles will be like this, right? So these are the poles, these are the general poles. Now what you have to do is, so what you have to do now is, this is the armature. Now you have to increase the length at this position, and the length here is same, but you have to increase along the sides. Okay, I hope you understand, right? So here the length increased, here uniform air gap under the pole shoe, but here this is not a uniform air gap. At this position minimum air gap, and edges there is more air gap. So because of that, okay, because of that, so the armature flux path is like this. So because of that, reluctance is increased. So if the reluctance is increased, flux will be decreased. So flux is equal to MMF by reluctance, right? So because of more air gap, reluctance is more. So armature flux will be reduced. So if the armature flux is reduced, obviously the effect of armature flux on the main field flux will be reduced. That is armature reaction, right? Armature reaction means the effect of armature flux on the main field flux. If armature flux is reduced, armature reaction is also reduced. So armature flux is reduced by increasing the reluctance by making the pole like this, that is camphor pole. Okay, and second one, so by using laminations in the poles. Okay, that means, so actually this is the pole, right? So this is pole. So now this pole construction is making with laminations. So that means so this is one lamination, and another lamination will be like this. So by placing this lamination on this, okay, along this, by placing this on this, okay, so it will look like this, right? If you place this one here, it will be like this, and again this lamination will place above this, and again this lamination will place above that. Okay, so similarly one by one you have to keep up. Okay, so there will be gaps. So okay, if you see from the top, it will look like this. So this is the top view. if you see from this point, so this is a top view. So this part will be here and this extra part will be like this. This extra part will be like this. So this is a top view. Okay. So there will be gaps here. Air gap will come. So because of, sorry, this is one. So because of this air gap, okay, so the armature flux is reduced. Okay, understand? So by using laminations, this is one lamination, this is another lamination. So keep this lamination on this. So if you keep this lamination on this, this one come like this. Okay. So again place this lamination on this and place this lamination on this. So one by one you have to keep like that. And if you see from the top, it will look like this. Okay. So this middle one come like this and these extra parts will come like this. Okay. So there will be gap in between them. So because of that gap, that means it is an air gap, right? So reluctance is more for the air. So if the reluctance is more, flux will be reduced. So armature flux is reduced like this also. Okay. And another one, third point. So this is also another way of reducing the armature flux by increasing the reluctance. Okay. In the machine. So by making rectangular holes, like this, okay, in the poles, okay. So if you make a rectangular poles like this, so here there will be armature conductors, so current is flowing, so armature flux will be like this. So armature flux now flowing through these holes, that means reluctance is more here because air is there. So reluctance is more, so armature flux will be reduced. Okay, so the combination of these three will make armature flux more reducible. Okay, the combination of these three methods will make the armature flux more reducible. So the armature flux is reduced, so the effect of armature flux is also reduced on the main field flux. So the armature reaction will be reduced. Okay. So now again another fourth point. So these are the three. And next fourth point, by making strong magnetic strong main field flux, okay, that means, so now what we have done in these three cases, we have reduced the armature flux, but in the fourth case we should increase the main field flux. Okay, you should increase the main field flux in the manufacturing process. Process only we can do this. We have to wound more number of turns in the main field so that the main field flux is strong, so that the armature flux cannot influence this main field flux more even in the loads. Okay, so that is the thing. Next, fifth one. So by using interpoles. Okay, by using interpoles. So interpoles means, so I have already explained this armature reaction in a graphical way. So this is a point where the flux is zero at no load, but because of the armature reaction, so there is some flux exists along the GNA, okay, along the commutation axis. Okay, so we have to decrease this flux. Understand? We have to minimize this flux. Okay. to minimize this flux, so you need to keep one pole here. You need to keep one small pole. Okay. Here. So that will be opposite direction. So the flux produced by this pole will be in opposite direction to this flux here. So that this will be minimized and will be become zero. Okay. So what is the pole you have to put here? So if you consider it is a generator, then this pole you have to keep here. Understand? So if you consider this is a motor, this pole you have to keep here. Understand? So the point is, what you can say is, so the polarity of the interpole, is same as that of the main field pole. Okay, is same as that of the main field pole ahead in the direction of generator. Understand? And you can say in another way, the polarity of the interpole is same as that of the main field pole behind in the direction of the motor. Okay, so if you consider it as generator, you have to keep the polarity of this pole as ahead in the generator, ahead pole in the generator and behind pole in the motor. Understand? So if you keep N here, so see N, the flux lines are like this. So that flux also come like this. So that will minimize this one to zero. Understand? So that is by using interpoles. So if it is zero, commutation process will be good, right? So armature reaction is zero here. So because of this extra flux only, the commutation process is poor. So if you reduce this one, commutation process will be good. Okay. So next one, compensating winding. So next one, compensating winding. Okay. So compensating winding means, so here there will be armature conductors. So current will be flowing, armature flux will be created. Okay. So armature flux, suppose let us the direction of armature flux is like this. Okay. So now compensating winding placed here, okay, in the main field poles, and there is a winding in these slots, okay, that is in series with armature, but the flux created by this winding will be in opposite direction to the armature flux. Understand? So that the effect of armature flux is reduced. So that the armature flux is reduced, so that effect on the main field flux is reduced. Understand? So the flux created by this compensating winding will be in opposite direction to this armature flux, so that the armature flux is reduced, so that armature reaction is reduced. Okay. Thank you.